नमस्कार, स्पार्क टुडे न्यूज में आपनो स्वागत छे। समाचार में बात करिए तो थाईलैंड नी चुलालोंकोन यूनिवर्सिटी ना सहयोग थी इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल एंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एसवीआईटी वासद द्वारा एक खास आंतरराष्ट्रीय वेबिनार नु आयोजन करवामां आव्युं हतुं। विद्यार्थियों माटे आ कोरोना काल में आंतरराष्ट्रीय वेबिनार नु आयोजन करवामां आव्युं हतुं। एसओटी अंतर्गत जे तमाम चर्चा विचारणा छे ते आ वेबिनार अंतर्गत करवामां आव्या हता। एसवीआईटी कॉलेज ना जे संस्थापक छे अने जे तेना फेकल्टीज छे तेमना द्वारा खास करीने आ वेबिनार विद्यार्थियों माटे आयोजित करवामां आवी हती, जेमां आंतरराष्ट्रीय जे कंपनीओ छे तेना नामांकित व्यक्तिओने आमंत्रित करवामां आव्या हता। थाईलैंड की चुलालोंकोन यूनिवर्सिटी सहयोग की इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल एंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट और आईएसए एट्ले कि इंटरनेशनल सोसायटी ऑटोमेशन स्टूडेंट सेक्शन एसवीआईटी वासद द्वारा सर्वेलंस आईओटी एप्लिकेशन्स माटे डीप लर्निंग बेस्ड विडियो एनालिटिक्स पर आंतरराष्ट्रीय वेबिनार आयोजन करवामां आव्युं हतुं, जेमां जाणीता आंतरराष्ट्रीय वक्ता डॉक्टर सुपावड़ी अमरविथ तेमनी साथे ज स्टेच्यू सरकारी यूनिवर्सिटीनी विविध समितिओमां विविध पोर्टफोलियोना संभाळी रही छे। तेमणे पोतानुं ज्ञान आवे वेबिनारमां पीरस्यो हतो। विडियो एनालिटिक्स अने तेनी सुविधा, सर्वेलंस विडियो एनालिटिक्स में संशोधन, मशीन लर्निंग विविध पद्धतिओ, लक्षण निष्कर्षण, सर्वेलंस विडियोज में असंगतता तपास, तेना माळखा वगैरे जेवा अलग अलग विषयों पर चर्चा विचारणा करवामां आवी हती। इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स एटले के आईओटीना आवनार दिवसोमां लोकोनी जरूरियात अने तकनीकी सहायना क्षेत्र में एआईनी भूमिका विषेनी विगतवार चर्चा पण करवामां आवी हती, जे ऑटोमेशन आईटी कम्प्यूटरना लोको माटे उपयोगितानी जाणकारी पण आपवामां आवी हती। खास करीने एसवीआईटी वासदना आचार्य डॉक्टर एस टी टोलीवाल द्वारा कोविडना आवा कपरा समयमां विद्यार्थीओ माटे आंतरराष्ट्रीय संस्थानी नामांकित व्यक्तिओने आ वेबिनारमां आमंत्रित करવામાં આવ્યા હતા અને આ એક આયોજન કરીને ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રી અને વિદ્યાર્થીઓને લાભાન્વિત કરવા બદલ ઇન્સ્ટ્રુમેન્ટ એન્ડ કંટ્રોલ વિભાગના વડા ડોક્ટર આરપી પટેલ અને તેમની ટીમને અભિનંદન પણ પાઠવ્યા હતા।
Learning based video analytics for surveillance IoT application organized by ISS student section and instrumentation and control engineering department SVIT Vasad. In this talk, Dr. Aramvith will present and discuss the current trends and research in video analytics as a surveillance camera has been widely installed worldwide. Although the main purpose of this camera is for monitoring, but the most important task is to be able to analyze video, contain and extract useful information.
This evening, Dr. Supamadi Aramvith, HOD IC Dr. Rakesh Bhai, other staff members of the Instrumentation and Control Department and student friends. I join my predecessor in welcoming the eminent speaker, Dr. Supamdi, this evening, who is going to speak elaboratively on one important applications of IoT.
As you can see, it's based on the data set that we have. I mean, if you can obtain many data set of a different type of the mole and so on that you have, then it is more useful because it's mean like, because in deep learning, you have several layers of the CNN and then it will extract, it will learn like a different type of the tissue or something that you have. Yeah, so it's mean like it has the, if you learn enough, then it is possible that you can classify, you can detect the symptom and so on. Yeah, it's based on the data set that you have.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Thank you so much.
Madam, hello, madam.
Yes.
I want to know, because you have done a lot of implementation of neural network into hardware and mm-hmm. different type GPU module you have discussed over here. So mm-hmm. I want to know, there are any embedded controllers of STM series which can, we can implement the neural network for various applications? Because there are a lot of types of neural network, Kohonen network one, and recurrent network, feedforward network. We have a many type of neural network. So how we can easily implement into embedded board? Which one is suitable embedded board to implement other than FPGA?
I see. But other than FPGA now, it's like, of course, there is a single board. But actually, FPGA now, like, there has a new, like, Intel, they released some new FPGA board that is like, but you need to use their platform and then library to be able to implement it too. It has some software platform that you can translate the code, I mean, into like the hardware. Yeah, language. Yeah, we did also try that But of course, it is an early stage. So it means like sometimes if we use the model from Python and so on, right? And it has certain library and so on, it is not available on that software platform. So like some, I mean, there is still some limitation, right? But you said the VLSI and so on, that, I mean, you can try on the new, I mean, FPGA. Other than that, it's gonna be like more of the single board computer, but it need to be with the GPU. Otherwise, it's still not possible.
According to your experience, FPGA is a good board for implementation of neural network.
Yeah, but of course not, that is the new type of the FPGA that's gonna replace the GPU. Yeah, but as we
okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Hello. Good evening, ma'am.
Yes.
Madam, what are the control aspect of the deep learning, or particularly non-linear control? How we can apply deep learning to the non-linear control system?
So non-linear control system. So yeah, you can use to learn the irregularity, in the system. Because when I talk about anomaly detection, is about the detect from the image, right? What we can see an abnormal, but if we think of like it as a one-dimensional signal or something like that, it can use the same concept, to learn from the normal and then try to identify the abnormal irregularity that happened in the nonlinear control system. But you have to be specific of what type of the problem is that.
Any more questions, participants? Any more questions?
Yeah, maybe there's not no more questions.
Yes, yes, maybe, yeah. Maybe. So on behalf of IAC student section, I thank Dr. Amravit Madam for very informative session and sparing her valuable time for us. I also again thank her for accepting our invitation. I thank our principal, Sir Dr. S.D. Toliwal, and management for permitting to organize this webinar. Last but not least, I thank all the participants for their cooperation and active participation in today's session. Thank you, madam. All the participants, you can please leave the meeting. If you have any query regarding the certificates, you can talk to our coordinators.
Madam,
one thing,
sir. There is a feedback link on the chat box. Yes. All participants are requested to fill the feedback link.
Uh-huh.
And madam, thank you so much for accepting our invitation.
So, madam, one question. I think. Madam, one question.
Yeah.
Ma'am, good evening, ma'am. I'm Rohit from Andhra Pradesh.
Yes.
Ma'am, can we use MATLAB for this process, ma'am, deep learning and machine learning?
I think there are, of course, there may be some library function for that. But as you know, MATLAB is a high-level language. So in terms of the processing speed, it's going to be slow. So usually they use Python.
Actually, I'm going to learn within this process in the MATLAB, and that's why I asked for your guidance. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you.
So today's session is over. I request all the participants to leave the meeting. Thank you for cooperation.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.